Commissioner work session today, Thursday, March 5th, 2020. Appreciate your attendance. We get right into the new business. First up, we have presentation of FY 2021 Council of Accountability Court Judges Criminal Justice Coordinating Council Enhancement Grant for Dawson County Treatment Court. Treatment Services Director Jesse Emmett.
And just by way of introduction, Jesse, you can go ahead and come on up here.
I sure say, boy, that job is done her in because she's completely changed.
Chairman Zimmerman, it's good to be with y'all again, and I'll just let Jesse give you the specifics on it. But just by way of quick introduction, Treatment Services, if you want to put a smile on the judge's face, you come in and finalize an adoption. But if you really want to know what's at the heart of their heart, what cranks their tractor, it's the accountability court that they preside over. And we're extremely fortunate to have the state funding. Georgia, in many ways, has led the nation in a new way of responding to criminal justice issues, and not just punitive punishment, but looking before they go through and wind up in our jails and in our prisons. And so I'll let Jesse kind of present to you for the next year what we requested from the state and what that requires from Dawson County.
So we are not looking to request much more than what we have in the past. I think that you have that paperwork showing that we were awarded for FY20. In Dawson Treatment Court, we're still asking to fund our two full-time counselor positions. For a long time, if you remember, we had a third full-time counselor position funded in that grant that was just left open for a long time. So last year we consolidated that and then used our contract counselors to help facilitate some of our groups, which we will continue to request for the next fiscal year. We will also continue to ask for community policing funds so that our officers can go out on surveillance visits and then continue with drug testing. So we will have money to buy supplies, like the collection cups and specimen bags, and then also for the labs that we collect 7 days a week. And we courier over to our home county lab for the actual testing and then send off for any confirmation. So last year we were awarded $2,900 roughly. This year we're looking at asking for about $208,000 in our grants. And it does come with a match from the county, which calculates to about $31,000. We'll use Kimberly Wallace, who is a county funded case manager. Salary, but
that's
the match
for
that grant. So that's the Dawson County Treatment Court grant. Any questions?
Questions for Jesse?
Okay.
Well, let's move on to the next one. You have one for Family Treatment Court.
Yes. So our Family Treatment Court is the newest program that we have. That started in January of 2019. It was a slow start to get that program off the ground. We are currently, as of today, up to 6 participants in that program. We are hoping to build that to at least 15 in the coming fiscal year. We hired a full-time case manager. She was with us for a few months, and then she left, and we had a position open for a while. That is now filled. So Megan Hill is the full-time case manager. We will continue to ask for funding for her position. What I am requesting this year that's different in the applications to the funding committee is that we're looking to share that case manager position with our treatment court. So currently, the one full-time case manager for treatment court oversees about 85 to 90 participants, whereas family treatment court's case manager has 6 people. So to appeal to continue funding, we want to share those resources. And so we'll split that caseload to more evenly have a workflow and a more manageable caseload for both of our case managers. We're also going to ask to bring the treatment in-house, like we're doing with family treatment or with treatment court. So instead of relying solely on our community service board because there's a lag in treatment, we'll be asking to pay those contract counselors that we have now, which is going to reduce our group size that we currently have, open up more options for groups such as parenting and life skills groups for all of our participants, and then that would take care of all the requirements that we have. Questions
for Jesse? A couple things. Both of these are 9-10 match, correct? And reading this, you need us to, if the board is willing, to move these to the 6 o'clock voting session so that you can get it in by the 20th, correct?
Yes, sir.
Y'all good with that?
Yeah.
Now the two treatment courts, we're doing like alcohol treatment, drug treatment. Are we doing any mental health?
Yes.
I know we went up there to that conference with Family Connection that invited us up, and that was a big problem. Mm-hmm. It's a big problem not only, the dose is getting a big problem with our kids now, especially the high school level and stuff.
Yeah. We do have a mental health court here. It's just under the treatment court grant umbrella. Okay. Instead of having it kind of separate.
So some of this takes care of that too?
Yes, sir. And we're hoping, again, in writing the narratives for this year's grant, we're doing a little bit different to show counsel accountability court judges that in Dawson County, we're really trying to stretch these funds as best we can, offering those parenting classes, offering mental health classes, co-occurring substance abuse to the right. It's not just affecting the folks that are in our program, but their children.
Oh, yeah. It was staggering, the numbers they gave us on high school kids. I mean, you wouldn't believe. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just.
There's always a lot more graduates of the drug treatment. I've seen this whole thing full right here, but I've gone to the HEP graduations and there'll be one, two, maximum three. I don't even know if I've seen three. So I don't know why, I don't understand exactly why there's such a disparity. I guess there's just more drugs or something. I don't know.
I think that it's kind of one of those, is the chicken or the egg, which came first, is it the mental health or the substance use? What we're seeing now is there's not really our treatment court, which historically has just been drugs or alcohol. Everybody that comes in, for the most part, they've got mental health issues too. And the same thing with mental health court. There's one of the two. So we're just trying to treat it all together.
They're not asking for that help.
Yeah.
That part.
Well, a lot of them go kicking and screaming from what they say when, go to the graduations, especially these help, because they just don't want to go and bothered, and it must be an intensive course.
It is.
And they want to quit and all that, but boy, when they get finished, they are just glowing. They are so excited.
That's right.
And they come up with some of the best. They have these PowerPoints and all that, and I thought, man, y'all, I'll be a teacher or something. It really works. It really does work.
Those graduations, that's what fills up our cup, and we appreciate y'all's continued
support. Yes. I love them. I love them. Those people are truly transformed. Money well spent.
We think so, and we appreciate
it. Yes, I think so, too. You put me down.
Any other questions for Jesse? Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
We'll move that to 6 o'clock.
Okay.
Next up, we have a presentation of request to accept FY2020 Violence Against Women Act Grant Award. Sheriff's Office Chief Deputy Greg Rowe. Greg.
Good evening, folks. I'm up for you again to ask for you all's acceptance of the VALOR grant, which is a Violence Against Women grant. We use the funds, which for this is $19,794 or federal with a match of $6,598 for the first basically 6 months of the year. And we use these funds to essentially pay our domestic violence investigator, and that's Jennifer Wright. And she did an extreme job. Unfortunately, today she's been very busy with her job, and some of these incidents may very well make the newspaper soon. Okay. And needless to say, unfortunately, she's very busy. It's a huge problem here. So we sure do appreciate the help with this from the federal government and from you all too to fund this position. We got it. Mm-hmm.
Questions for Greg?
All these things interrelate. We're just talking about the treatment court and the help, and then you come up with this. And
I was thinking the same thing. Mm-hmm.
It's so bad. Does Jennifer work some with DFACS and
She's been asked to sit on one of the boards, and unfortunately, I can't recall at the time, at this particular time, but she's been asked to sit on a board involving DFACS, and I wish I could remember it exactly, but she's very, very much involved in that, very much detail oriented with that whole process.
Well, I don't know how she stands it, but I'm glad somebody can.
Amen. Sure.
Other questions for Greg? Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Greg.
Okay. Is that getting moved as well to the new?
No.
They didn't ask for that one. Right. Next up, we have presentation of applications for parade and assembly. Third annual Sheriff's Office Motorcycle Ride for Charity. James.
Thank you, Chairman. As you stated, this is the third year of this event. April 4th, they're looking to start at the courthouse, the city hall. They're going to be traveling around the county, as you see in your in the application. Our staff is taking a look at the application. The only thing that actually came back is from Public Works. It says that they are going to be doing road work on Kelly Bridge between the four-way stop and the Etowah River Bridge, and that the participants should use caution through that area. I'll answer any questions.
You got plenty of debt to escort on.
No problem.
Did you, it says on here you're waiting on the GDOT approval. Did we get that?
So we've yet to receive the GDOT approval. We got the last piece of information submitted over to GDOT this morning.
We don't expect any
problems, but we should have that back before it's voted on in a couple weeks.
Did I read where it said there's possibility this may not run through Dawson County? That if it was rainy or something other, I thought it said there's possibility the route may not be.
And that and would
may
not
even
be
have
this
to
event.
Be.
I believe that would be the next thing on the
okay, this different one.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, excuse me.
They have off duty officers are going to be with this one?
Yes.
I mean, they'll all be off duty officers.
I believe so.
All of them.
Well, I was concerned about that since it's...
That was a poor attempt of a joke, I guess.
Other questions for James? All right, we'll move on. Presentation of application for Praise Assembly Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation Atlanta Ride for Kids. James?
So this is the second year that this event has come through Dawson County, and I believe this one is the one that they have alternate routes in case there is rain
right. And
other things. So this one will start at the Cumming Fairgrounds, comes up around our old courthouse, and then back to the Cumming Fairgrounds. So they will only be utilizing Highway 9 South for this event. It will be on June 7th between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. And they've submitted everything. The application is complete. There was no quarrels with any of the county staff on this particular event.
Have we looked at the schedule of the roundabout down there? Because it seems like they're talking about trying to get caught up in some weekends and doing some closures. And that might be a key question. With the double roundabout there at Dawson Forest and 9 South. Because I assume this is a Saturday, isn't it? June 7th.
Yeah.
Seems like I've heard that they may try to get caught up on some rain delays on some weekends, and we just need to be cognizant if they're doing any road closures during that same weekend that we try to figure that out. If that's a concern.
We'll post that. Absolutely. Huh? We post that on the web. On county web.
Well, I'm talking about, if they're riding through there, we'd have to coordinate
there's
that.
There's going to be one lane traffic always, but no total.
No total closure.
No,
okay.
That's my latest effort.
Well, I've heard they close it down for periods of time. Flagging is what the
but it's still.
Right, okay.
They may be inconvenient.
Right.
It's all due that right away, so there's always that possibility of inconvenience there.
Mm-hmm. Other questions for James? Thank you, sir. Next up, we have presentation of the Board Appointment Long Range Planning Committee. Cal Miller replacing Ronnie Atkins. Lamar Atkins was the appointee of Miss Julie's, and I called Miss Julie and talked to her about Mr. Miller, who was more than willing to serve on this committee. In fact, he had sent in three committees that he was willing to serve on, and this was his number one choice. And Commissioner Nixon said that if he was that willing to serve, she was okay with that. And so with that, I'll make a recommendation of Cal Miller to you for the Long Range Planning Committee.
So is he out? He's out for the tree preservation committee. So we got to do somebody up. I know we got a Hess.
Yep.
Will we need
one
another
more.
One?
Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
So next time you go to the store,
I know,
somebody
next time I go to Eagles, I'll hunt sometimes.
Get somebody else. County manager.
Thank you, Chairman and Commissioners. Just a few recognitions. The Dawson County Parks and Recs 14 and under basketball team won the District 7 championship last Saturday in Jefferson. The team will now travel to Thomas McDuffie County to represent Dawson County in the GRPA state tournament. Congratulations. I'd also like to recognize this morning, some of you may have attended, but the Rotary Club hosted a ribbon cutting this morning at Rock Creek Park's new action item island, I'm sorry, sports complex. If you were unable to attend, I encourage you to go to take a look at the new pickleball, basketball courts, and batting cages. Over the past 6 years, Rotary has invested over $157,500 in different contributions for things that they've put together in the county. $71,000 for Rotary Island, $39,000 for Action Island, $5,000 for handicap playground equipment, $35,000 for school system interactive panels, and $7,500 for the Bowen Center Art Deck. So that's just a few of the items that they contributed to. Speaking of the ribbon cuttings, I'd like to remind everyone again tomorrow at 3 p.m. we will host a ribbon cutting ceremony at the new transportation complex. We will look forward to seeing everyone there to look at the new public works fleet and scale house. Also like to recognize Christy Rutman attended her second to last, she's an HR, human resources specialist. Attended second to the last class foundation of public human resources management for the GPA certified human resources manager. She was approved for her final project dealing with health promotion within the county and will complete her certification this fall. Erica D'Amico recently attended a seminar on the FMLA and will be attending other Fred Pryor HR seminars this month. In addition, Human Resources is sponsoring a benefits information and enrollment session for the county employees on the first Tuesday of the month. February saw approximately 17 employees met with retirement, health, and supplemental benefits specialists from ACCG, NFP, and AFLAC. Also got just a couple of new companies that will be coming in. Coming in at the Outlet Mall, Marc Jacobs, Sperry, and Skechers. Monarch and the Old Kroger is getting one of the storefronts ready for another customer. One Life Fitness in the new Kroger Shopping Center. Secura Teriyaki next to the Senior Fiesta in the new Kroger Shopping Center. Stanton My Eye Lab in the Public Shopping Center. Womack Mini Storage, Auraria Road. And the subdivision on the corner of Harry Sosby is beginning land development. And the realignment of that will be done by the county, of which the county secured the $50,000 to $60,000 from the developer for the design of that roundabout. So just a few little projects that are going on or upcoming. And that's my report.
Questions of the county manager?
Not a question, but just a comment. The continued news that we hear about the coronavirus thing. I appreciate y'all stepping on that, and Danny as well. He's in the back, and just not to raise alarm for the community, but to know that we've got we're thinking through these processes. There is a plan in place for these type of things. We've never had to implement it that I know of, but there is a plan, and we have leadership in place that's addressing that. So thank y'all for that.
Yes, sir.
They're currently working on updating our plan that we put together originally in 2006. And so Dan's working on that now, and we will have a meeting on the 12th to finalize some of those updates. So, yeah, we're trying to be very proactive in that and stay ahead of anything that might happen. County attorney report.
I do not have a total report tonight.
Do we have a need for executive session?
I don't think we do, unless there's any pending matters that board's interested in discussing.
Not loading.
Well, with that said, I did send something for y'all to sign tonight, so maybe we should gather for just a moment on pending litigation and get those verification documents filed. That's with respect to the D5370 lawsuit.
Okay.
It'll only take just a minute, just make sure we have that.
What else you're gonna need to ask too about land?
Yeah, we can do both.
Okay.
All right, so I'll entertain a motion to go into executive session for litigation and real estate.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Fawcett.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Gaines, discussion. Hearing none, please vote.
I need one more.
And that's approved 4-0. There'll be no vote coming out of that, correct? No vote? Right, thank you all for your attendance. Encourage you to stay for our 6 o'clock voting session. We'll take about 5 minutes and then we'll go into executive session.